and smashed it up. Now, normally when I do a speech, I just do a rant. But today I've prepared a mind map. Oh. The Badgercom. The Badgercom, please. Please get involved. Please turn up next year when they try the Badgercom again. Or if, try and stop it before next year. Please, please, mobilise. And that's what we've got to do, mobilise. And, I mean, I'm surprised. I don't know if any of you people can see me, because I'm not on Facebook. And that seems to mean as if they say you don't exist. Get off your fucking computers and get back on the street. Use your computers for contacting people. Tell people all over the world about our beautiful demo. Whether you're people down in your street, for your neighbours, get off your computers and mobilise and come back on the street. Whose street? I'm so happy, man. I tell you, Anna, do you know what I said about her? I don't know anyone here. I know that there's about 10 people I know, which is amazing, brilliant. I'm so glad I only know 10 people. And there's one guy here called Mel Broughton. Let's big up for Mel Broughton. Oi, oi. He had to get special permission today from a special branch to come here because he's under some of these fancy conditions I've got now. He cannot actually speak. He cannot speak to animal rights people with a criminal record. He can't actually say hello to me today. And this means he's literally lost all of his friends because I joined the movement in the 80s and all the people from back then. We've all got criminal records, basically. So Mel lost all his friends. Hopefully you haven't got criminal records. So, where's Mel Brower? Where is he?
Of the suffragettes who chained themselves to those railings. Hi everyone, my name's Alice, but other people know me as Ali. I'm from an organisation called the Save Move Burton. I'm an organiser for West Yorkshire Save. What we do is we go outside slaughterhouses every week. We stop the trucks. We bear witness to the animals that are suffering. We give water to these animals. We document the conditions these animals are in. In Toronto, I don't know if you ever heard of Anita Crank, but she is currently on trial for giving pigs water in a truck on the way to slaughter. She is why we are here. In the UK we have 22 groups now, and if you have not been to a local Save group, you should all get active, start your own group, or go to a vigil. These animals need a voice. Sitting on at home on your computer sharing photos of your food is not being a voice. They need you on the front line, taking their photos, taking their videos, comforting them and sharing their stories. We have people who eat meat that come to our events. We get them to go up to the trucks. They reach into the trucks and they cry. They say they are sorry to these animals, and that is what we need. It's not easy what we do. It's incredibly hard. I find it incredibly hard because I used to pay for this to happen. I'm sure a lot of you used to pay. And that's why I go. I go and I tell these animals that I'm sorry. My first experience of bearing witness was with Manchester Pig Save at a place called Tulip Beats in Ashton under Lyne. This slaughterhouse, they kill 3,000 pigs a day, they gas them. They have public footpaths next to the gas chambers, and you can hear the workers beating the pigs up. You can hear the pigs screaming. On this day where I went, people stopped and jumped in front of the trucks, and I reached into the truck, and a pig looked me in the eye. I cried my eyes out because I used to pay for these animals to be killed. And none of them deserved this. They were just babies, they were 6 months old. This was the first time they've ever seen daylight. This was the first time they've ever had the smell of fresh air, and they were about to be killed. And this is why I bear witness, and this is why everyone here should get themselves to a slaughterhouse and bear witness. These animals need us, not in 12 days, not in 12 years. They need us now, because lives are getting lost at the end of the day. We have, Tolstoy, if you've ever heard of him, and the quote is, "When the suffering of another creature causes you to feel pain, do not submit to the initial desire to flee from the suffering one, but on the contrary, come closer, as close as you can to him who suffers and try and help him." And we have it written on the back of some of our t-shirts, and we use this quote a lot because we believe it is incredibly important to go to those who are suffering and do whatever we can to help. I mean, it's hard, even though it's called Save, can't save more, but in the long run we will save them. We have rescued animals, we have a rescued pig called Leo, we have 4 rescued hens too, and we will continue to rescue these animals, and the more people that join, the more animals we can rescue. So if you want... Stop the killing! Stop the murder! The time is now, animals need us, until every cage is free, until every slaughterhouse is closed down, until every hunter's red coat is hung up and the hounds are packed away, until the magic blows over, until the laboratories are burnt down. We need to stand up, not only march, but take direct action for these animals, because we're all that they have. Thank you. I'm working on the job. He recently started coming to our vigils, and he's an incredible activist. I can't even explain it. He's recently set up a Save group here in Nottinghamshire, which have a vigil next week, I think, on the 1st, yes? What animals is it that you're bearing witness to? They're going to be bearing witness to pigs in Nottinghamshire. So if you live near Nottinghamshire, please get yourself down. Now I'm going to hand you over to Tom, who will talk to you about his experience of bearing witness and setting up a group. Thank you.
I'm Tom, recently co-founded Nottinghamshire Animal Save. I'm basically just talking a little bit as a new co-founder and why it is that I've started it. When I first went to Bear Witness, it was in Essex. I didn't know what to expect. I was just one of the drugs that might turn up. So I got out, sort of met with a couple of friends, all of a sudden somebody just shouted truck. And when you hear the word truck in that context, you'll never hear it the same way again. It's like, first of all you see it, and then you smell it, and it just smells like feces and mud. And then you see them, and all of a sudden, people just start gathering up around the trucks, and I just saw eyes, like 100 eyes that had done nothing wrong, nothing to deserve anything that was going to happen to them. Months old, and they had already seen more suffering than I have known in 30 years on this planet. And I tried to approach them, comfort them, some of them came at me, some of them backed away, and then they were gone. Just like that, in an instant. And they didn't do anything. They didn't do anything wrong to anyone to deserve that. And it is so important. I've thought to myself since then, like, what if it was me? What if I was in that truck? What if I was covered in the filth of my friends and my family as I was being driven towards my death so that somebody could eat my corpse? And I know that I would want people on the other side of that truck. I would want people trying to reach to me, trying to give me water, telling me that they loved me and that they cared. I would want to see somebody fighting for me and for lives like me. And there's thousands of people here, and it's a brilliant testament to what we can all achieve. There was a scene with Yorkshire last week, and only 6 people turned up. The animals need more of us. Together we can all do more, and we can all do better. We can do better for them. That's why I started with my girlfriend and my friend, Nottingham Shrine All Saints. So, as a new organiser, basically, I hope that this encourages all of you to get out there and attend saves, or start one of your own. I mean, right now, as I'm saying this, as everybody has spoken, as we've all sat here and marched through London, thousands of throats have been slit. And everybody here has fire in them to do something about it. And the animals need that. They need every single one of you.
I I can't believe that I'm here doing this. You know, we started out planning this march a few months ago, and to see what's running now is incredibly humbling. It's made me incredibly emotional because I see so many passionate people in front of me. And at times it can seem so helpless for us. I know we go about our daily lives and it seems that we are alone. And the society doesn't care about the plight of animals, the plight of the environment. And it can be incredibly overwhelming for all of us. But this is a reminder for everyone here today that you will never, ever be alone. This is a fraction of the vegans in our country. And we have to be the voices. But you will never, ever be alone. That's what I want you to know today. Because I know we can feel that way, but you never are alone. For our emotional well-being, but more than we have to stand strong for the animals. The 3,000 animals that are mercilessly slaughtered every second in the name of food, in the name of clothing, in the name of medicine, and cosmetics, we're a disgrace. We're a disgrace! I cannot believe that we are here fighting for this! I cannot believe these animals are not being given basic fundamental rights that we have to put these marches on. That makes me so angry! Does it make you angry? I can't believe we have to stand up and make the politicians and the general public listen to our demands. We are supposed to be a compassionate species. Do we not hear this every day that we're evolved, right? It's what we get told as vegans. We're evolved. We're above animals. If we're above animals, then why can't we start using emotions like empathy? That's what's supposed to make us more evolved, right? Our emotional capacities. So why don't we use them? Why don't we show empathy and compassion and mercy to these innocent beings that have never done anything wrong to us? They are innocent. They're more innocent than every single one of us because most of us have been complicit in their murder, complicit in their slaughter. And although we are making changes to do what's right, that will never change. And that is why we have to dedicate our lives to fighting for them. Because we once were their oppressors, and we once were the things that stood in the way of equality and freedom for them. So let's not sit idly by and think that we're doing enough by simply not eating or wearing them, because that is not even close to being enough. Because while there are people out here that still think it's acceptable to eat them, and still think it's acceptable to wear them and test on them, we will never be doing enough. We will never have done enough until it's all over, until all animals have been liberated. We're here today fighting for the rights of the animals, fighting for the rights of the environment, and fighting for the rights of humans that are also oppressed in the animal agriculture industries. So let it be known to everyone around today that we will never be quiet. Now. Content live in this world, a world where compassion is foreign, a world where compassion is extreme. How can we possibly allow ourselves to fit into a society that thinks compassion is extreme? What a ludicrous world we are living in. We have to take a step back, and we have to do what's right for everyone. We have to do what's right for the planet, because if we carry on the way we're going, as you all know, we'll have no planet to live on. It's imperative that we all become active, and I know many of you might be sitting here in this today for every single one of the speeches, but we are going to keep telling every single vegan, you have to be active. It's the only way. The only reason any of us are vegan today is because of activists standing up, not because people sat and didn't do anything. Their rights to minorities, their rights, there's activists that have to give animals their rights. But we have to stand against all oppression and make our voices heard. So I just want to say thank you so much again, like I truly am humbled.
It really is, I'm a junior. think of anything to do, I encourage you to bear witness again and again and again and again until you remember what you should be doing with your time and who you should be spending your time with, because what's more important? We're talking about the biggest social justice issue of our time happening right now. Victims.